Hello everyone and welcome back to the Planet Zoo Tours. Finally, we are back with the tours on the channel. I'm sorry that it has been a while, but anyway, we are back. And today we are going to take a look at Dýra Gardur. I think I pronounced that perfectly, which is Icelandic for zoo. Yeah, very fitting name. By Citroën Vert. So you might remember that name, which is also the creator of another zoo that we toured on the channel. The little French zoo with the beautiful castles and stuff. But this time they created a Icelandic themed zoo. And I got the following description. It's pretty short. A medium-sized zoo inspired by Iceland and its architecture. And apparently there's an Easter egg. I already found it, but I will show it probably in the end of the video. There are quite a few blueprints in this zoo, so if you might recognize your work, there is a link down in the description featuring all the creators that have contributed to this little project. And just so you know, there is a link down in the description to a form which you can use to submit your zoo for the Planet Zoo Tour, so I will take a look at it on the channel. So without further ado, let's jump into it. So as usual, we are going to take the tour in Tegetgam, which is basically the guest mode. So you have the guest view, which is perfect to it for a tour like this. And as you can see, we just arrived with this little boat over here. And over here we have this beautiful entrance building. So let's walk towards this side. So as you might remember from the previous episode, this creator doesn't really mind the piece count. But actually, the frame rate is pretty okay. We are in we're not even in pause at this moment, so I think that will be fine. This project is a little bit smaller than the previous one. So as you enter over here, some beautiful flags. There will be a little explanation in the end of the video, so make sure you stick through until the end. But yeah, over here we have the entrance, Dýra Gardur. If you're from Iceland, please let me know if I pronounced that correctly. But anyway, we are going to enter this beautiful building. As you might hear already, there is some nice background music. I always love that. And over here, we can buy our tickets. There's already some information about the animals, but look at this. It's just a beautiful build. I hear some Planet Coaster music. Very nice indeed. So after we get our tickets, we can walk over here. A beautiful map on this side. I like that. This is actually the island. So over here we have the big building, a smaller building, the church, which is over there. Very well done. And then we have a little description over here about the zoo. Nothing to see behind closed doors, which is the same as the previous project that we looked at. There's an Easter egg. Raise the black flag. The black flag is not on the map. Ooh. Very interesting. Okay, let's see. So the donors. So all the people of which blueprints have been used in this project. Some really familiar names over here. Yeah, we have some nice gift shop items on the left. So I guess these are also a blueprint. Probably the plastic swans things. I recognize them over here. Really well done, but look at this building. It's beautiful. Really nice. A really cool view as we go along this side. And we have the next building. Once you step outside, you can see this beautiful foliage work. I don't even want to know how many plants and stuff are in here. Are these like groups or... this is a bush. That's well done. That's really well done. I like that. Like that very much. Some nice little art pieces over here. And you can already see. Oh, this is cool. I love that. Reindeers. Walking along this beautiful toilet building. I like that. I really like that. So, let's go to the right on this side. Some nice costume fencing over here. And let's go on top of this. And over here we have the American Bison. This is really cool. This is just an extremely 1700 pieces for only this little thing. But how? Why is that 1700 pieces? Please explain it to me. But anyway, we have the beautiful bisons on this side. Look at that view. And look at that foliage. Beautifully done. costume fencing all around the place. And then on the other side, I can already see the next building and some wolves as well. They are they're separated from each other. I think that's a wise choice. Oh, we have another board over here. The same thing. Probably again 1,700 pieces or 1,800 almost. Really nice. I like that. I like that a lot. So I did do some research, and most of these buildings are actually inspired by some buildings which are actually in Iceland. So if you recognize some buildings, make sure you let me know down in the comments so I can take a look at that. In the meantime, we are going to take a look at this restaurant. I'm not sure where the entrance is. Let's see if I can find it. It's right over here. Some really nice and modern and clean architecture over here. I like the use of these little pieces. What are they called? Opaque walls. And they are perfect for these kind of themes. And then the floor is the same thing, I guess. On a metal clad. I like that. I like that. Really clean and really modern. Some other blueprints, I think. Perfect fit for this area. I like the music. I'm not sure if that's custom. I don't think so, but yeah, it looks cool. Anyway, this is a great use. Is that nice? This is really well done. I never seen this one. This is really cool. I like that. I like that. This is a refill station probably for your soda and stuff. So yeah, just a nice little view from the other side, and you can already see the next building in the background, which is the Indian house. So yeah, we will walk towards that side and we will take a look inside that house, of course. So the Indian house, again, some nice background music. And over here we have the entrance. Just make sure you also take a look. Oh, there's actually an animal over there. Wait, I almost forgot some animals. Let's take a look at that as well. Red panda over here. And yeah, I recognize these. So these are Rudy Rank camels. Some nice blueprints, but this habitat is really amazing. I love that. I love this little statue on the back. It's only 18 pieces, but still it's really well done. I like these. What are these? Why don't I come up with stuff like that? It's horrible. I like the walls. It's a really nice idea. Unfortunately, always have to do something like this with the terrain so keepers can actually enter it. Otherwise, it would be a perfect place for these animals. It's still a perfect place, of course, but it's really nice. Let's take a look from this side as well. I did see some red panda sleeping over there. Very nice. But yeah, the Indian house. Let's go inside. I like the rope pieces over here. So you have to go through them. And let's see which animals do we have in here. Not sure. I do see some... oh, there's a crocodile actually. So a saltwater crocodile in here. Really, really nice. The nice little water areas. And I like the walls. Let's take a look at the walls as well. 1,100 pieces, of course. These are all bamboo pieces. The bamboo walls. And then some separate bamboo pieces as well. All recolorable. So you can... I almost didn't recognize them. And of course, some custom fencing all around the place. Really cool. Another map. I like that. I like that. So we have maps all around the place. Saltwater crocodile. Some nice information. And probably, of course, again... Yeah, 1,800 pieces for these sites alone. And let's see, what do we have in here? I can't find it, but it's probably a sign. A Bengal tiger. I do hear them. I can't see them. Let's see. Maybe from this side. Oh, I think there's one over there. Right inside a tree. Yeah, there is a Bengal tiger. Right over there. And on the other side, we have the Indian elephants. Really cool. I don't think normally this would be big enough if you're playing franchise or whatever. But of course, this is a sandbox zoo. So it's all about the design, and that's extremely well done. And on the other side, over here we have the gharials as well. But look at this building. Look at that. So it's, I guess that it's based on a building in Iceland. I'm not sure. I would love to see that building. I'm gonna go to the outside just to give you guys a better look at this building. But look at how big that building is. It's really huge. It's a really like an eye catcher. If you enter the zoo, you can already see this building. I'm just gonna walk through the entire foliage work and stuff. I really like the building. So in the Indian house, we also have some peafowls. Oh, that's cool. I almost missed them. And also a giant forest scorpion. And I guess some staff buildings in there as well. But look at these peafowls. Look at them. All happy. Very nice. Also, if you want to take a look at this zoo yourself, there is a link down in the description to the Steam Workshop. You can download it over there. And of course, you can take a look at this beautiful build. But in the meanwhile, we are going to take a look at the Bear's Dome. So we are going to enter the building from this side. And let's see, what do we have here? Another really modern building, a lot of glass. I always like that. A lot of information about the animals, and I'm guessing that this is like a viewing area for the grizzly bear. Let's take a look if we can find them. So this is the habitat for the grizzly bears. Just gonna walk around. Beautiful rock work on this side. Really well done. Blended in with the terrain. And on this side as well. That's really cool. I guess this is the shelter space. It's really dark in here. And let's see if I can find some animals. Nice little water section on this side. Yeah, over there. I found them. No worries. There he is. A grizzly bear. Enjoying his dinner. I like it. Really natural. Really nice environment. I like the building. It's clean and it's a lot of glass, and that's always good in this game. I think the modern theme in this game is really, yeah, I wouldn't say easy to build, but we have a lot of pieces that fit it perfectly, and everything in Planet Zoo is like really clean, if you know what I mean. So yeah, that fits the modern theme perfectly. So yeah, the grizzly bear on this side. I'm guessing that we have some other bears as well. This is the Formosan black bear habitat. And we already found them. So he's stealing the show on this side. So guests can take a look at him. There's one swimming as well. You can see. Oh, there was a little freeze in the game. But anyways, let's walk around the habitat for a bit. Of course, some beautiful foliage. That's just really well done in this project. I will take a top view in the end of the video so you can see the entire project and see all the foliage around it. But that's just amazingly well done. And I think that really separates this project from the previous one. I think the foliage work on this one is a lot better. You really improved on that one. And yeah, I just love it. On this side, Himalayan brown bear. Let's take a look at the habitat itself. And over there, we have a bear sitting next to his last night's dinner. And some water section. This actually could be a zoo in this area, I guess. It will probably cost you a lot of money to remove these hills and stuff to make it look like this, but yeah, I would see it as a zoo. I like this building a lot. You can actually see that in a zoo. It will cost you a lot of money to make it, but yeah. I'm guessing polar bears on this side. Yeah, so a really clean habitat. A bit of snow. Oh, I love that building in the back. That's really cool. We will take a look at that later. So yeah, the habitat itself, a lot of snow, some ice, some rock work, and I'm guessing some shelter space for the animals on this side. And then we have a beautiful fencing and a beautiful polar bear, again, eating, of course. All these animals are always eating. I love this one. I love this one. So let's walk along this side and let's go to the church that we just saw. So this is still the entrance. Let's walk towards this side. And you can already see this beautiful church. Yeah, take a look at this building, guys. I really love this one. This is beautifully and really well done. Really well done. It's simple. I'm just guessing that this roof must have been a pain to build. But yeah, the structure itself is pretty simple, but I really like it. I don't have any words for it. But yeah, we also have some animals over here. Of course, the Japanese macaque. And let's take a look at this habitat. Beautiful fencing, by the way. But I think that is also a blueprint, but I'm not really sure about that. But yeah, you will see it down in the description. But let's take a look at these animals. I love this idea of like a hot spring for these animals. You will, yeah, if you think about the these animals, you always think about hot springs. So really well done with the little mist effects over there. But yeah, look at this building. Let's see if I can find a nice spot for some screenshots. So look at this view. This is just amazing. So I'm gonna take a screenshot, and this will probably end up being the the thumbnail for this video. So let's walk along this path. I do see some animals over there. Of course, the llamas. Yeah, these fences, I recognize them. They were in the previous project as well, in the countryside. So the llama on the in this habitat. Again, the piece count on this is probably amazing. If you look at the rock work, I really like that. It's really different from what I normally do or what I see other people do. And it's refreshing, and I always like refreshing ideas. All these projects always give me a lot of inspiration. So I'm really happy that it's back on the channel, and hope you guys are as well. And if you are happy that it's back on the channel, make sure you hit that like button. It really helps me out a lot to grow this channel. So another view on the llama habitat from the other side. So we just walked around the Indian house, and we are still in the llama habitat. I like the terraforming a lot. I like the foliage a lot. It's really different from anything that I've seen before. The zoo decides to freeze for a bit, but that's just the piece count that we have to deal with. But I'm already happy that I can tour this zoo while it's on play, and we don't have any further issues. Just some freezing here and there, but that's all fine. And then on the other side, so on the back we have the llama, and on this side we have the dall sheep. Of course, they fit perfectly into this area and into this zoo, with the snow, with the rocks. It's there's someone shouting at me. But yeah, it fits perfectly. Again, this beautiful sign, and I still don't know why it's such a... Oh, wow. Are these all individual pieces? These are all individual pieces, guys. That is just amazing. And that also explains a lot, of course, why this is, 1688 pieces. But some nice information about these animals. And I think that was missing in the actual game. So I like that. I like that a lot. So over here we have the Siberian tiger. Let's take a look at that. Rockwork. Yeah. Just amazing. Just amazing. Well done. Well done. I can't really find this Siberian tiger. But it might be underneath this viewing area. So let's take a look from the other side, so we can actually see the viewing area as well. Let's walk along this path. Let's see. So I just entered the habitat just to take a closer look at this amazing rockwork. And I also changed the settings, by the way. I forgot, so I'm sorry if the beginning of the video make you a little bit nauseous, but I slowed down the camera speed a bit. But yeah, this is a viewing area, so on top of that you can actually see the animals, and it also functions as a shelter space, and I like that. It's a really cool idea to do it like this. And we have the animals inside, of course. So it's running towards me. So yeah, that's very terrifying if a tiger is running towards you. But some nice fence work on this side. And yet again, this rock work. You gotta love that. And the foliage, of course. And all the views that you have around this zoo. It's a beautiful project. Okay, so after the Siberian tiger habitat, I think we missed out on another habitat on this side. And this is a great use of the temple pieces. Look at this. I guess this is based on some natural scenes in Iceland. But these are the snow leopards. And I don't even want to know how many temple pieces are in here, but I'm going to take a look at that. Anyways, there are 288 and some different groups in here. And the rock work. Yeah, I've said it too many times, but yeah, the rock work on this project is just amazing. It's so incredibly well done. I love that. I'm going to take a lot of inspiration from this one when it comes to foliage and rock work. It's beautiful. In the beginning of the video, we also saw some viewing areas along a timber wolf habitat, and I didn't see them yet. So I'm going to walk around the Indian house again, and I see some nice little staff buildings in this. That's cool. Really simple, but nice. I think this would be perfect for the Steam Workshop. I guess a lot of people would use this. I like that. A nice little bridge. And then we go to this viewing area. We have some artwork in here. And a trillion pieces again to make a really nice dome roof. On this side we have some animals. So these are the Arctic wolves, of course. We couldn't miss them in this zoo. Let's take a walk around the habitat itself. Nice little water feature. And I don't think the animals can climb these walls. These are too high. And let's walk along this side and take a look at that. It's beautiful. I can't really see where the habitat ends, because I'm guessing the animals can just climb this and, you know, walk everywhere. But I guess it might be blocked by these trees. So the animals always do this when I come by. I don't know, I have this effect on the animals, but yeah, again, foliage, amazing, love the habitat, love the building, love this little viewing area. Really well done. And I think we can also walk towards the other side for the timber wolves. Yeah, and this is what we saw in the very beginning, the timber wolves walking along this habitat with the beautiful church and entrance building on the back. So we've walked around the entire zoo in Tajitken, and I just want to give you guys a quick overview. So we entered the zoo right over there. We have the beautiful church over here, and yeah, this is the only thing I missed out on, I guess. The reindeer habitat on the left side of the church. I'm sorry, we didn't take a look at that in Tajitken. We did see the animals walking along this toilet building, and it's a really great idea. So we have the Siberian tigers over here. We've had these two separate habitats, or three actually. You have the beautiful church on the back, and you will have this bear dome with all the different bear species around it, the Indian house, and then of course the bisons and the wolves on that side. And of course, in the beginning of the video, I promised you the Easter egg. So there are a few different flags in the beginning of the zoo or at the entrance, and this is where they stand for. So we have the Icelandic flag, the Pride flag, the NB flag, and the ACE flag. I actually never seen these. The last two, but it's really interesting. A nice little Easter egg going on over here. So these are actually the flags that we were talking about in for the Easter egg. And as usual, we will end this video with some nice shots from this zoo. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this new episode of Planet Zoo Tours. And if you did, please make sure you hit the like button. And if you didn't do it already, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you won't miss out on anything new. And if you want me to show off your zoo on the channel, make sure you join the Discord as well. And there's also a link down in the description towards the Google form, which you can use to submit your zoo for the Planet Zoo Tours. And I will speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye.